Good morning. This is Susan from All in Stitches in downtown Polson, Montana. Welcome to another Saturday. So what's the stitch? Poppy and I, come here Pops, are on our way to work this morning. Sun looks like it's going to peek out here pretty soon. It's going to be a beautiful day. If you don't have anything else to do today or you don't want something special to do, come on downtown. Check out the stores. We've got lots to see, lots to do in downtown Polson. We'd love to see you. You know, there's a nail spa, there's Main Ideas, 219 Main. Poppy, hold on 1 second. I gotta go rescue my dog from across the street. She doesn't seem to mind too well. Come here, Pops. Yeah, this is a come on, Poppy. Poppy, come on, you. Come here. Yeah, she thought she'd maybe go on an adventure herself this morning in downtown Polson. So we're going to take her into the store, close the door, and keep her contained a little bit. Okay, come on, into the store. Keep going, into the store. Yeah, but be sure and check out downtown. Men's clothing store, of course, good coffee roasters for the best coffee in town and baked goods. Come on, Pops. Okay, sorry for that crazy intro to our morning. So the store is looking good. Girls spent yesterday moving some fabric around, trying to highlight different things, show you some other ways to look at some of our product. We always, have great samples, can put kits together if the kits aren't already made. So come in and see us. I know a lot of you today are probably busy with graduation. I'm going to see if I can turn this thing around and get a picture of me on there instead of just, let's see, continue broadcast. I can't figure out right now how to get myself on there instead of just looking at the shop. I know it's here somewhere. I'm missing Jess this morning. The way they are. If I can figure out how to get it turned around to look at me, we will. But we'll just look at the shop real briefly as I talk to you a little bit this morning. I know a lot of you are busy this weekend with graduation. I know Flathead is graduating. I think Missoula has some graduations. Polson's probably graduating this weekend. And with graduation, a lot of us make graduation quilts to give away to grandkids, kids, special friends, that type of thing. I know I just gave one to my third grandson on Thursday. I was quite proud of myself for having gotten it finished on time. But as I thought about the quilts that I've made, I was thinking, I wonder how many quilts I've made in my life. And I looked around my living room this morning, and just in the living room and a couple of the main floor bedrooms, I have over 8 quilts made. And then upstairs, there's some applique wall hangings that I made. There's a couple of other quilts. One of my highlights right now is a quilt that's on my guest bed. I didn't make it, but my great-grandmother and my grandmother made it. I think my mom maybe embroidered a block that's on it. And one thing that's special about it is it has the names of the people who made the quilt. And that's got me thinking about the quilts that we give away. Do you always put a label on them so people know who they're from, when they were made, and a little bit of the story behind them? It's important to do that. You know, we think, oh, well, they'll remember that, you know, Grandma made that, or Aunt Sally made that, or, you know, my mom's best friend made it for me. But they probably won't at some point. So do take the time to put a label on the back of your quilt. Whether it's just a piece down in the corner that you've used a permanent marker and put who it's to, who it was made by, and the date. Or if you're going to be a little more particular and maybe design a label of your own. We have these sheets here. They're called EQ printables. You design a label on your printer, run the block through, cut it out, maybe put a little bit of border around it, and sew it in the corner of your quilt so that it documents who that quilt was made for. And how many of you, along with documenting your quilts, keep track of the quilts that you've made? I have no idea. I all of a sudden was thinking, oh, I probably made 15 or 20. And then, like I say, I looked around just the living room and a couple of bedrooms, and there were 8 quilts there, plus 4 wall hangings. I know I've got probably a dozen quilts out in my sewing room that need to be quilted. But I've given, you know, each of my 4 grandkids have had a couple of quilts, made a wedding quilt for my youngest daughter, have got to get one made for my oldest daughter, even though they've been married for 5 years now. But it's, you know, keep track of your quilts. Maybe take pictures of them, document them somewhat as to when they were made, what pattern was used. Because I probably, as I think about it, have made, in the neighborhood of 25 or 30 quilts that I've given away. You know, some of them small baby quilts, others, bigger quilts. But keep track of it. Start just a little diary. Take a picture, do whatever. But keep track of what you make. And be sure and label them. So along with that, we introduced last week that we were going to have a contest each week. And the contest started last week. If you watched to the end of the show, you know that today we were going to ask a question about what had happened in last week's show. So the question for today is, I introduced a fabric last week. I'm going to give you a little bit of a cheat here and show you the fabric. But what you need to know is, who is the designer of that quilt, or of that fabric? I told you he started out as a graphic designer, but the first person that I find with a comment that tells me who the designer is will get a $10 gift certificate. That would be good either in the store or online. So watch the show to the end. There will be a question about today's show. I'm not sure what it is. It might be related to that naughty little puppy Poppy who ran across the street instead of staying with me. Or, you know, it might be related to my inability on the phone to actually get it turned around and take a picture of myself. But appreciate your watching today. Have a good weekend with graduations, parties, whatever you've got going. Stop in to downtown Polson, Montana. Shop at All in Stitches and find out what the stitch is. This is Susan. Have a great day. Bye.